Oh, say, can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say, does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave? And with this year's Independence Christmas Walk and all the other Christmas delegations and decorations across the Commonwealth of Kentucky and our great United States of America, God bless this country with godly principles and love. And just remember, amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now am found. 'Twas blind, but now I see. 'Twas grace that taught my heart to fear, and grace my fears relieved. How precious did that grace appear the hour I first believed. Through many dangers, toils, and snares, we have already come. 'Twas grace that brought us safe thus far, and grace will lead us home, and grace will lead us home. Saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now am found. 'Twas blind, but now I see. 'Twas blind, but now I see. This world is not my home, I'm just a passing through. My treasures are laid up somewhere beyond the blue. The angels beckon me from heaven's open door, and I can't feel at home in this world anymore. Oh Lord, you know I have no friend like you. If heaven's not my home, Then, Lord, what will I do? The angels beckon me from heaven's open door, and I can't feel at home in this world anymore. I have a loving mother just over in Glory Land, and I don't expect to stop until I shake her hand. She's waiting now for me in heaven's open door, and I can't feel at home in this world anymore. Oh Lord, you know I have no friend like you. If heaven's not my home, then Lord, what will I do? The angels beckon me from heaven's open door, and I can't feel at home in this world anymore. Praise the Lord. Lift the spirits and just remember. The old song I learned from George Beverly Shea and Cliff Barrows and Billy Graham's crusade. At a very young age, 1956, riding with my little sister Judy Felty Stephenson, all the way from Kenton Baptist Church to the one-room Baptist Church, Kenton Station, Kentucky. Riding down with Vernon Likens, Carl Covey, Walter Roden, and John Grizzell, and Brother Kerger, a pastor, and his wife Polly, carrying myself and Judy, many other young folks, on the old rickety church bus, all the way to Louisville, Kentucky, from Kenton Station, where we heard the message of Billy Graham, John 3:16, and heard the message. It's the Holy Spirit's job to convict, God's job to judge, my job, our job, to love like Jesus loved us. For Jesus, his only begotten Son, died on the cross to save us from our sins. All we have to do when the Holy Spirit knocks on our door is to reach down and turn the knob and open the door and invite Jesus into our hearts. Make a U-turn in life and work for the Lord. And just remember, coming home, singing this song. I'd rather have Jesus than silver or gold. I'd rather be his than have riches untold. I'd rather have Jesus than houses or land. I'd rather be led by his nail-scarred hands than to be the king of a vast domain, or be held in sin's dread sway. I'd rather have Jesus than men's applause. I'd rather be faithful to his dear cause. I'd rather have Jesus than worldwide things. I'd rather be true to his holy name than to be the king of a vast domain, or be held in sin's dread sway. I'd rather have Jesus than anything this world affords today. God bless. bless America. God bless Kentucky. And God bless home right here in Taylor Mill and Independence, in Northern Kentucky, where I was born and raised. And over in Campbell County, where Miss June was born and raised. Or in Boone County, all the good times we have out in Boone County. The triple counties of Northern Kentucky. And all the areas of Northern Kentucky, where many of our families originated down in Grant County, or Pendleton County, or Gallatin County, or Mason County. You know, wherever you were born and raised, whatever country you were born and raised, the Holy Spirit knocks on your door at some time, and you can answer the call. Reach down, turn the knob, and invite Him into your life. Let Him lead your way. In all things, let Him lead your way. Proverbs 3, verses 5 and 6. In all that you do, follow the lesson of Jesus, and He will make your pathway straight. God bless you all. Have a great Christmas. Be sure and watch our Santa Claus Education Series and Santa Claus Entertainment Series, which both tell you the real meaning of Christmas. The real meaning of Christmas is Jesus Christ and His love. So you kids out there, you seniors out there, you adults out there, no one's too old to watch Santa and His Education Series, and Santa and His Entertainment Series, and enjoy yourselves. And remember, the greatest gift God gave us is the gift of love. The gift of love. For God gave His only begotten Son, that we should not perish, but have everlasting life. John Stephenson here, with Miss June Diamond Stephenson, always working for the Lord. 859-750-0000. Join us on Facebook under John Stephenson, Stephenson, or on YouTube under John Stephenson, Travels with Dr. John Stephenson on YouTube. You can watch all of our shows there. And folks, don't remember the hard times, remember the good times. And the good times are listening to WIOK 107.5 FM on the radio dial. Send them in a little contribution to help them keep them on the air. The great ministers, including Billy Graham's daughter, Ann Graham Lyon, Adrian Ryan, David Jeremiah, Michael Houston, Carl Martin, all of the great ministers, including the owners, Gil and Jan Hammond, the stewards of our Christian radio station, 107.5 FM. Send that contribution to Post Office Box 50, Post Office Box 50, Falmouth, Kentucky, zip code 41040. That's Post Office Box 50, Falmouth, Kentucky, zip code 41040. This is John Stephenson, former Superintendent of Education, Commonwealth of Kentucky, the old country boy. We love you, and God loves you too. Amen.
Now, we happen to be out here today, and I've done a lot of video work on what was done here with McCollum Pike and McCollum Road and over Cox Road all the way over to Highway 16 by this highway project here, the Department of State Highway Roads, and And of course, I had the honor of being a former Deputy Secretary of Transportation under Dr. Poor and Martha Lane Collins many years ago, and Commissioner of Motor Vehicles for the state of Kentucky. And I'm really appreciative, as I've said before, all the hard workers out here with the Eaton Asphalt Company and the other asphalt companies in the Commonwealth of Kentucky. But I watched particularly all the workers here and pointed out to you all the hard work they did, even in cold times, and in keeping and maintaining our roads here in Kentucky. We have two gentlemen here right now with Eaton Asphalt, the company that did all of this work and did it so supremely. Now, introduce yourselves, Clay, right?
Yep, Clay Lampert.
And
Delbert.
What's your last name, Delbert?
Andrus.
And two gentlemen that are supervisors and workers with Eaton Asphalt. I just wanted to say, as former Deputy Secretary of Transportation, I was very proud to watch all the men and how they worked and the care that they took in doing the job right. I've ridden the whole road. It's smooth as silk and painted very well. And it'll move a lot of traffic quickly and safely. And that's what you're all interested in, right?
Yep, yes, sir.
Well, God bless you for your work. And all of the other companies we mentioned before, Lynn Riegler, who's been around for a long time, his company. And even though they're competition, you all get along and work well with them, don't you? So God bless you and thank you very much. Anything you want to say to the listening public?
Nope, our pleasure.
Well, God bless you all and take care. Nice to be here with you today.
Thank you.
Traveling on Wolf Road here, and many memories. Right there, Dudley Martin lived and grew up in that house. Married to Shirley Mills, Simon Kenton class of 61. And Gary Halberstadt lived down here. His father, the Halberstadts. And there's where I lived right there, where I was born. 3589 Wolf Road. There was Hope Williams' house and Mrs. Culberson over here. Henry Culberson, wonderful people, lived next door to us here. Sitting here on Wolf Road brings back many memories of where I was born and raised here for the first 8 or 9 years of my life. Here in Taylor Mill. Mom and Dad had this house built that you're looking at here on Wolf Road. It had about 2 acres here. Dad gardened that acres. And Mom canned the fruits and the vegetables. Of course, it's got a nice garage on it now. But I remember sleeping upstairs. Remember our basement with the old cold fired stove. Furnace, and it was a beautiful place to live. Wonderful neighbors, and the Culbersons and the Williams, Hope Williams, and his wife Henry Culberson, the Halberstadts across the street. Still, remember Gary Halberstadt and his wonderful wife still going strong, and the Williamses and the Bells and the Luzaders. Donna, bless her heart. And the Armstrongs, the Dieters, Charlie Dieters and his family, brothers, Jerry Dieters. A lot of memories here, the memories of the story, my mom gathering the signatures to keep in planning and zoning to keep the taverns from going in a
and bars from going in at the end of the street, right off of Taylor Mill Highway, Highway 16. So Nick's Grove, even though the land had been promised in a gambling debt, so to speak, they had to move on out, further out 16, and that's where Nick's Grove eventually opened up. Did a great job out there. But Mom was not in tune to have them on the end of the street, particularly probably because of the alcohol problems that so many men had back in those days. And Dad had those problems and worked his way through them. One of the ways he worked his way through it was he almost killed us all in the car one time. We were riding to church and he was coming home from work and had been drinking and ran into us. Could have killed us all. And I think that was the day he actually stopped drinking. And I was just a baby at that time. And the real story is that he grew on up to be a wonderful Christian man. Throughout his life, lived to be 86 years old, died in an automobile accident in the arms of a Baptist minister. Used to walk from here on Wolf Road all the way down to the Louisville-Nashville Railroad where he worked, and his father worked before him, but his father was crushed to death between two cars down there. At work one day on the southbound hump. The very hump that Dad worked on as a switch tender and I worked on as a, what they called a hump jockey, later on a retarder operator for the Louisville-Nashville Railroad in the 60s, early 60s. Dad retired from there. I worked my way through college and started there and went on to Frisch's and Telephone Company and a bunch of other companies and finished up down at UK. But we grew up right here. Barbara rode the train from here back and forth to Eastern Kentucky University. Judy and Gerald went off to the service, to the Korean War conflict, served in the service and was a master sergeant and a ski instructor in Hakaida, Japan during the war for the soldiers in the Korean War. And Barbara and Gerald both have gone on to heaven now. And Mary Ruth is still singing. She was dated the guy up the street here a ways called from Taylor Mill Church of Christ. His name was Jackie Robinson. He was the minister, or one of the ministers. And she wound up marrying him, and they started a life traveling the whole United States singing. Had four Greyhound buses and two semi-tractor trailers, traveling the whole Canada, Mexico, and all the states in the United States, singing at all the truck stops and fairs and carnivals, and they'll be singing again this December the 7th down at English Christian Church for their Christmas show that they do each year. My nephew Mark Robinson and his wife Sharon and the kids and some of the other Robinsons will probably be back together. They all gone in different directions since Jack died a few years ago. Mary Ruth's probably about 84 now, and still jumping up and down singing and working full-time at Walmart. Bless her heart. Little Judy, she went to school and she was the youngest of our five. She graduated from Cumberland College, was Miss Cumberland, the queen of the college. I got to escort her in the Mountain Laurel Festival one time. Tremendous honor. She was a beautiful young lady and married now to Don Felty. Felty Associates, financial consultants in up close to Fairfield, Ohio. And Judy, she's had some accidents in cars. It's cost her a lot of bones and breakage and sight. So she has a tough time getting around. But she's, her heart's filled with Christian love. And her husband Don is an excellent financial consultant for people that need one. Felty Associates, Don Felty. And this, the old country boy here, is still singing and producing television shows, over 1,500 of them now. And you can see our Santa Claus Education Series. Folks in Kenton County can see it on telecommunications board, what's called public access. You can see it there, and I'll post the dates you can see it and the times you can see it. And you can also see them on my Facebook site, John Stephenson, or on my YouTube site, Travels with Dr. John Stephenson, former Superintendent of Education, Commonwealth of Kentucky, the last elected one. But we had some great times here. It's a wonderful home, thanks to Mom and Dad. I never will forget Mom telling the story about riding the bus out here and talking to Boss Spears and putting down the money on the down payment for him to build this house for them. Boss Spears, who built a lot of the local churches around, built a nice home here for him on Wolf Road, right at the top of the hill. I can remember Ricky Williams and Rita Williams. Ricky Williams and we used to play together on this road, and a lot of the other kids. We had great times hunting and fishing down at the end of the bottom of the road down there in the little creek on Visalia Road. This was a very steep hill, still is, going down Wolf Hill. Very steep, very dangerous. Don't try to ride it down there on a bike without brakes. I can tell you, wind up in a house across the street. We had a lot of fun here. And in honor of the house here, I'd like to sing for you a song I've sang in every county in Kentucky, all 120 of them, when we filmed the history of all 120 counties. And that song is taught to me by Happy Chandler when I was president of the student government at Northern Kentucky Community College of the University of Kentucky. And we helped gather the signatures up there to get the four-year college established in 1968. And it was really quite a effort to do, and a lot of people were involved in it, including two state representatives I'd like to mention, several of them. Phil King in particular, and Art Schmidt, and from Campbell County, Phil King from Kenton County, representing this district we're sitting in right here. And of course, Ken Harper played a role, and Clyde Middleton played a role, and Johnny Eisler and Gus Sheehan played a role, Senator Sheehan. They all helped out and pitched in, and Jim Murphy and Terry Mann and Bill Donemeyer over in Campbell County, and Don Johnson, Senator Johnson. And it took everybody's efforts in Northern Kentucky, including Walt Dunleavy, the Chamber of Commerce, and Philip Talaferro, a great attorney, probably one of the best known barristers in the Commonwealth of Kentucky. And I never will forget even my young friends, the Dallas boys, David and Danny and Steve Dallas and Dennis. There were four of them. They even lived with us for a while right here in this house. And for several months, they lived with us, and we became just like brothers. And Steve Dallas, of course, right now, he's sort of semi-retired, but he, from being Commonwealth Attorney out in Boone County, Kentucky, but his daughter is running for County Attorney, which is really a unique pleasure to see that happen. She's a beautiful lady, and a beautiful lady in more ways than one. Beautiful lady in beauty, and a beautiful lady in Christ. And I was fortunate enough to film her the other night when she made her announcement and had her little gathering, quite a sizable gathering of people from all over, including the county attorney in Kenton County, coming over to endorse her and talk about her. But I just really want to say she's Jordan Dallas Turner. She's a very fine young lady, Christian lady, who's running for county attorney in Boone County. And we'd be quite proud of them, and so would the Dallas boys. And I know her father, Steve, is very proud of her and her mother. And so, in honor of that family and all the other family members that were active in Latonia Baptist Church and Kenton Baptist Church, where Judy and I gave our life to the Lord on a trip to Louisville to hear Billy Graham preach. And some great men took us down there. Walter Vroden, John Grizel, Vernon Likens, Mr. Kobe and Walter Vroden took us down there with Brother Kerger and Miss Polly, his wife, and a minister on that old rickety church bus down there to hear Billy Graham in 1956. Ladies and gentlemen, that's a long time ago, 1956. And that's where I learned one of the other songs I'll sing for you a little later here. I'd rather have Jesus. But this is a song that Happy Chandler taught me. Poked me on the chest and said, son, I'll teach you how to sing it, but you got to sing it from your heart. So when I pull in here in this driveway of old Williams's, I don't know for sure who lives here right now, but the driveway was vacant, so I'm using it. And got the camera set on the house that we lived in, grew up in, and it goes like this. Oh, the sun shines bright on my old Kentucky home. 'Tis summer, the children at play. The corn tops ripe and the meadows are in bloom, and the birds make music all the day. Oh, the children roll on the little cabin floor, all merry, all happy and bright. By and by, hard times comes a knocking at the door. Then my old Kentucky home says goodnight. Weep no more, my ladies, oh, weep no more today. We will sing one song for my old Kentucky home, for my old Kentucky home far away. Weep no more, my ladies, oh, weep no more today. We will sing one song for my old Kentucky home, for my old Kentucky home far away. For my old Kentucky home far away. God bless you, Mom, Garnet, Bingham, Stephenson, Dad, Alton, Charles Stephenson, and my sister, Barbara Branner Stephenson, Gerald Stephenson, his wife, Dorothy Stephenson, and Barbara's husband, Jay Branner, Joseph Branner, who sit in this house a many a day courting Barbara. I never will forget meeting him, and what a wonderful experience it was having him as my brother-in-law, and Dorothy as my sister-in-law. And next came Mayor Ruth and Jackie Robinson. And they went with me on my first campaign across Kentucky when I ran for Commissioner of Agriculture, and they sang their hearts out, them and all the children, and I have a picture of them and us sitting in the old Greyhound Silversides bus where we rehabbed it, and thanks to the good folks at vocational school put it all together, and we used that Greyhound bus to travel through half the state of Kentucky. We ran out of funds, so they had to take off on the road and did so, trying to make their living after they had sang with me all across the state. And they traveled the whole western part of the United States, making their living, and I went on running with Gerald singing with me by car, and we finished that race for Commissioner of Agriculture. And the story goes on, the two of us got it finished, and we were ahead in the polls, but we were out of funds. And so we decided, when two multimillionaires got into the race, were good men, Bev Yeiser, and he was supported by Julian Carroll and Tom Harris, and he was supported by Wendell Ford, and I was supported by lots of grassroots Democrats at that time. But I could not defeat all those funds. We had about $10,000 spent, and that's about all we had to spend. And I refused to mortgage the house to go ahead and try to run further. So I had to bide my time until I got my chance to run for Superintendent of Education for the state of Kentucky. And we won and became the first person elected to any constitutional office in over 70 years. And so I take great pride in that and honor when I was elected Superintendent of Education in 1992. And that was the year my father passed away, but he got to see me elected. So, and Mom, bless her heart, she died in 1965, and was a wonderful Christian woman, as everybody will attest to. She was about as best a mother a young fella could ever have, and she helped Gerald by signing him up to go into the Army, and had to sign the papers for him because he was so young. But it was a good thing for him to do, and he wound up living his life for the Lord at Oak Ridge Baptist Church with a fellow out there by the name of Randy Wallace, who brought him to the Lord. And what a wonderful minister Randy Wallace is. I've got a couple good ministers over right now where June and I go to church at Bethesda Community Church, little Baptist church on Mount Zion Road. And coming back from that crusade in Louisville after giving our life to the Lord, Judy and I both set out to be baptized. I was baptized in the Licking River. She was baptized in Visalia Baptist Church's baptismal, because we didn't have one in the little one-room Baptist church that we belonged to at Kenton Station. But when Mom passed away, that was the same year that Dad turned the shovel over to build the new church there with all the other deacons in the picture. So they have a new little Baptist church out there, Kenton Baptist Church. That's doing quite well. And the old one still stands, the old wooden one still stands there in Kenton Station, one room Baptist church. And one of the songs I sang when I came back home was this one, The Old Rugged Cross. On a hill far away stood an old rugged cross, the emblem of suffering and shame. And I love that old cross, where the dearest and best for a world of lost sinners was slain. So I'll cherish the old rugged cross till my trophies at last I lay down. I will cling to the old rugged cross and exchange it someday for a crown. Oh, that old rugged cross, so despised by the world, has a wondrous attraction for me. For the dear Lamb of God left his glory above to bear it to dark Calvary. So I'll cherish the old rugged cross till my trophies at last I lay down. I will cling to the old rugged cross and exchange it someday for a crown in the old rugged cross, stained with blood so divine, a wondrous beauty I see. For the dear Lamb of God left his glory above to pardon and sanctify me. So I'll cherish the old rugged cross till my trophies at last I lay down. I will cling to the old rugged cross and exchange it someday for a crown. To the old rugged cross I will ever be true, its shame and reproach gladly bear. Then he'll call me someday to my home far away, where his glory forever I'll share. So I'll cherish the old rugged cross till my trophies at last I lay down. I will cling to the old rugged cross and exchange it someday for a crown. And exchange it someday for a crown. God bless the old rugged cross. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. And thank you, God. And thank you, Mom, Garnet Bingham Stephenson, Dad, Alton Charles Stephenson, Barbara, Mary Ruth, Gerald, Judy, and yes, even little Johnny. God bless you both. That reminds me of our Scottish heritage and the Irish heritage. Old Kenny Brown, he used to love to call me up and say, John, come on out here and sing this song for me. My fundraiser. He was a county clerk in Boone County. Him and Al Wood, you couldn't beat those people for county clerks. Bob Kling over in Campbell County. They've had some great county clerks, and we got them right now in Kenton County and Campbell County and all the counties in northern Kentucky, including Grant, Pendleton, and Gallatin. And I've met them all. Had some of them on my television shows. Wonderful people. And the song goes, old Danny boy, the pipes are calling from glen to glen and down the mountainside. The summer's gone and all the roses falling. It's you, must go and I must bide. But come ye back when summer's in the meadow, or when the valley's hushed and white with snow. It's I'll be here in sunshine or in shadow. Oh, Danny boy, I love you so. But when ye come, and all the flowers are dying, if I am dead, as dead I well may be, you'll come and find the place where I am lying, and kneel and say an Ave there for me. And I shall hear, though soft you tread above me, and all my grave will warmer, sweeter be. For you will bend and tell me that you love me, and I shall sleep in peace until you come to me. When Irish eyes are smiling, sure 'tis like a morning spring. In the lilt of Irish laughter, you can hear the angels sing. When Irish eyes and hearts are happy, all the world seems bright and gay. When Irish eyes are smiling, sure they steal your heart away. Oh, the Irish eyes. When the Irish eyes are smiling, sure 'tis like a morning spring. In the lilt of Irish laughter, you can hear the angels sing. When Irish hearts are smiling, all the world seems bright and gay. And when Irish eyes are smiling, sure they steal your heart away. How wonderful to be able to sing these old songs here, sitting right beside Moffat Road. Let's see if we find another one here we might want to try to sing. Let's do this one for the children. The history of Jesus loves me, this I know. Divided as we might be, Easter is a time for all of us in the world to thank Jesus for his love and compassion by giving his life on the cross and resurrection so that we may have salvation. Are you ready? I asked that time in our television show. Are you ready? That's the name of the television show. Are you ready? Imagine what they thought on the day after his crucifixion, which occurred in the first century Palestine, most likely between AD 30 and 33. Jesus' crucifixion is described in the four Chronicles, Gospels, referred to in the New Testament epistles. June Guyman Stephenson gave me this information from a friend, my wonderful wife, Miss June Guyman Stephenson. Friday was dark. Friday was death. Friday was mourning and weeping and pain. Sunday was light. Sunday was life. Sunday was rejoicing and crying happy tears and hope. But what about Saturday? What about the Sabbath? What about the middle day? What was going on? How were people feeling? We don't really know a ton, honestly. The disciples scattered, they fled, they ran, they hid. I'm assuming they were scared and unsure, probably in a state of shock and disbelief, wondering if they were next, maybe mad, but that all changed with the resurrection. Yes, Jesus does love us. Are you ready? Have you invited him into your heart? He's knocking on your door. Knock, knock, knock. Turn the knob and invite him in. That's all you have to do. Turn the knob and invite him in to your heart. Jesus loves me, this I know, for the Bible tells me so. Little ones to him belong. They are weak, but he is strong. Yes, Jesus loves me. Yes, Jesus loves me. Yes, Jesus loves me, the Bible tells me so. Jesus loves me, this I know, as he loved so long ago, taking children on his knee, saying, let them come to me. Yes, Jesus loves me. Yes, Jesus loves me. Yes, Jesus loves me. The Bible tells me so. Jesus loves me still today, walking with me all the way, wanting as a friend to give light and love to all who live. Yes, Jesus loves me. Yes, Jesus loves me. Yes, Jesus loves me. The Bible tells me so. You know something? I have really enjoyed coming here and singing and being a part of just watching the beauty of the neighborhood here and people pulling in and saying hello and enjoying themselves. And it's really nice to say hi to them, be a part of their lives. Little beautiful cottage here on Wolf Road. So I'd like to close this program today, this time we have. Go meet Miss June and get her cars gassed up, and both of us are going to head to Skyline for a Coney Day, the good Lord willing. Thanks to that young fellow by the name of Holland who graduated from Simon Kenton High School. He's done a lot of building and going to put in some Roy Rogers over here. And just think about it. I'll be able to look out there and sing that song. Happy trails to you until we meet again. Happy trails to you. I'm glad you are our friends. Old Roy Rogers song. Well, Mr. Holland is going to be building some Roy Rogers in Ohio and Northern, all the counties of Northern Kentucky. So praise the Lord for that. And let's close our program today while we're looking at the little house we grew up in, thanking Mom and Dad and all the people in the neighborhood that we've come to know, including those who live here today. Our spirits with them. We ask the question, are you ready? Are you ready for the Lord? Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, power, and glory forever and ever. Amen. Just remember, it's the Holy Spirit's job to convict. It's God's job to judge. It's my job to love. Our job to love. Today we've tried to bring you a little love here on Wolf Road in Kenton County, Kentucky. Place where I grew up as a small child. So God bless you today. Travels with John Stephenson and Miss June Guyman Stephenson. See us on Facebook or on YouTube. And don't forget to watch our Santa Claus Education Series. That'll be on Spectrum Cable on the Public Access Channel. We'll show some pictures of the times it'll be on, starting this Saturday with the Christmas walkout in Independence, Kentucky. They'll have their Christmas walkout there, and Santa will be out there moving around, and I'll be there, and so will Miss June, having a good time with the people in Independence and all around the counties. So watch us on YouTube, Travels with John Stephenson on YouTube, including our show of Europe by Train, our Santa Claus shows, all of other shows we've got on there. Be sure and go to church on Sundays. Go to any church that you can see and get in the church and be a part of the church. As Bill Guyman used to say, there's a chair waiting for you. Out at Bethesda Community Church in the Fort on Mount Zion Road, we've got chairs out there waiting for you. And you'll have a wonderful time. Come out there. Bring the kids out to this singing. He is great, and he'll be out there singing this Sunday for kids. It'll be a great kids show. 10:30, come out there Sunday. Or go to Randy Wallace's church, Oak Ridge Baptist, or any of the other Baptist churches out here, Christian churches, or the cathedrals, or the Catholic churches. Find a church, regardless of what the church's name is, find a church to go to. There's a chair waiting for you. And love, share love. That's extremely important. And we hope you enjoy all the shows that we've tried to put together for you. In Jesus' name we do ask it. Amen. God bless you and have a great day. Give us a call if you got a question. 859-750-0000. And tune in my favorite radio station. My favorite radio station. WIOK 107.5 FM on the radio dial. 107.5 FM on the radio dial. And with Gil and Jan Hammond and all the great ministers that we love so much, and the great Christian music and great factual news, honest news, objective news, there on WIOK 107.5 FM. And if you want to become a partner like I am, I'm a partner with them. If you want to become a partner and help them out a little bit, or just send once to one time, down to their address, and that is Post Office Box 50, Falmouth, Kentucky, zip code 41040. Just send it down there to them. They can use the help. They painted all those tires and got them better. That one's 500 foot tall. Tires that send out the waves to get us all this radio music and news and everything. A great station, WIOK and WIDS down in Russell Springs. Gil and Jan Hammond, they need our help. I think it's $30,000 just to paint that tire. Goodness gracious sakes alive. So help out if you can. And if you can't, just pray for them. So God bless you and have a great day. Signing off now, John Stephenson here. .3589 Whoop Road. Praise the Lord. Wolf Road. Right across the street over here, where Donna Luzader and Phil Resman live, we did our Bible study class there with them. Had a great time doing it. Donna Luzader. Show you this great park that they have up here. Wish they had this when I was a kid. But that's the Taylor Mill Park. Beautiful.
Allison Rose Funeral Home is. Beautiful setting. And back onto the main Highway 16 south. We'll head down here and have some Skyline Chili with Miss June. I guess I decided to, since we signed off there, I'd have to show you a little bit of Taylor Mill out here, and out the new highway. And I wanted to, really, to be honest with you, I wanted to go out by Randy's church, and because Randy Wallace is a unique personality. He is a unique minister. He is a minister from the heart, and a wonderful gentleman. Now, we're just passing there, Taylor Mill Elementary. A lot of our classmates at Simon Kenton went to Taylor Mill Elementary. And there's Calvary Christian School. They got a great school there too. They do a good job at that private school, I'd have to say. Wonderful teachers there. And Latonia Lakes out here. They have widened this highway all the way out, 16, like they did with 17, going out to Independence. And see coming into view now the Oak Ridge Baptist Church. That happens to be the Baptist Church with Randy Wallace that I go with just every fourth Friday. Randy and I still go down to the homeless shelter. Well, we call it homeless shelter. It's actually called the Fairhaven Rescue Mission. And I remember Mr. Hammer, that was the director, passed on, and I sang at his funeral. And we've been going for over 20 years with my brother Gerald was alive with the Whosoever Will group. And several of them have gone on to heaven, but as well as my brother and my sister Barbara, who used to go with us. And I told you about my sister Mary Ruth, December the 7th, having their Christmas show down at 12 o'clock at the English Christian Church. If you want to get a ticket to that, you need to call them. Look them up on the Robinson Family Singers on Facebook and get your reservation in for a wonderful Christmas show with Mary Ruth and several of the kids and their kids. And Randy and I go down to the Fairhaven Rescue Mission every fourth Friday and enjoy singing and talking to the men there, being a part of that. But Randy has been the minister here for 30-some years. I guess maybe a little over 30 years. But I'll tell you one thing. He is a unique, wonderful Christian man. And it's a warm Christian church there. And as I always say, being Baptist won't stop you from sinning, but it'll stop you from enjoying it. Well, Randy is a Baptist, and he's a Baptist Christian. And he's about as nice as man as you ever met. And he was wonderful with my brother Gerald, and who served as a deacon there for him before he passed away.
Tri-State Gospel, WIOK.
570.
Southern Kentucky Gospel, WIDS.
I guess that gives you an idea what I'm listening to. And it's a great, it's my favorite radio station with some great music. Let's listen a little bit. Well, I pulled over here because I see they're working down here, so I want to, don't want to block any traffic down here.
gone to heaven here this year. And Mike Conley has been working with this company for decades. And it was one of their experts on heavy equipment. Regular blacktop, yeah, they are doing it, so that's good. Is Mike here with you today? Also are hard workers and very diligent, and do a great job. So I like to, as I plug them, Eaton Asphalt, I want to also plug Glenn Rigler Asphalt and Blacktop. Do you know Mike Conley? Do you know Mike Conley?
Yeah.
Tell him John Stephenson said hello. Tell him John Stephenson said hello. And I'm putting it on Facebook. You're all doing a great job. Facebook and YouTube.
I know you.
Oh, do you?
You got Bernie Conley?
Oh, yeah. Yeah. Well, God bless you. Thanks for doing a good job. You're all doing a great job.
Thank you.
You're doing a great job.
Thank you.
Tell Mike Conley I stopped and filmed you.
What's your name?
John Stephenson. God bless you. Doing a great job. Lynn Rigler and Mike Conley and... And as Farmer's Deputy Secretary of Transportation, I really appreciate these workers that come out here in all kinds of weather and with traffic problems and do this work to help us maintain our roads here in our state highways and our city roads and county roads. And they do a great job doing it. And Judy was kindly Mike's wife, was my hair. Wife's hairstylist for 30 some years, and they're a wonderful family, and they work hard, and Mike's always been a hard worker. He even helped me, Lynn Rigler and her group helped me on my house when I was building it over on 213 Beechwood Road, and one of our homes, we built another one on 127 Seville Court, and then the one out here on 3L High, or on Moffitt and Martin Rhodes, who I've videotaped before. We built the house out there. Of course, now we live on McCollum Pike at that little house, 38 McCollum. And in fact, we'll be having a supper with the owners of the
radio station in just a little bit. We're going to meet them out at Skyline Chili, Gil and Jan Hammond. So don't forget, folks, if you enjoy our shows, travels with history, all 120 counties, our trip to Europe, a train, all educational shows, and our Santa Claus Education Series, which will start this Saturday, and we'll have it on YouTube and on Facebook, and it'll be on Spectrum Cable in Kenton County at the Independence Christmas Walk. So tune us in, get the children to watch the Santa Claus Education Series and the Santa Claus Entertainment Series. It'll be very helpful to them, very educational. Talks about Christmas, but also talks about the real meaning of Christmas with Gil Hammond speaking. And I like to say at WIOK 107.5 FM. Great music. Great music. The great American flag waving for us while we're singing. WIOK 107.5 FM on the radio dial. Gil and Jan Hammond, Post Office Box 50, Falmouth, Kentucky, zip code 41040. Send them a little contribution and help them stay on the air. This wonderful music ministries.
Down from heaven he came to teach us of our worth. Hope is not forsaken now, the light has shined on earth. Blessed be the day of our Savior's birth. Try as we may to make it on our own, we all need a helping hand to show us where we're going. Back in the days when those
kids coming home from school. Simon County School. Where I graduated in 1961. One of the greatest schools in the Commonwealth of Kentucky. I'm a little biased. But that's okay. It is a good school. Good teachers, good principal, Mr. Reinhardt. Good superintendent here in Kenton County, Superintendent Schools. Good school board. You better believe we got a good school board. A lot of good teachers, the great teachers.
WIOK 570 Southern Kentucky Gospel WIDS.
Get our gas here at Kroger's because we get a little bit of discount by buying our groceries here. When the angel came,
God would be born a baby. Jesus would be his name. Joseph stayed by her side to face the questioning eyes that honored to take this journey of faith one step at a time. With hope leading the way.
Thank you folks for being with us today, listening. It's a really an honor to have you listen to our music and our station and our videos that we do. I hope it educates you and teaches you some things too. But we love you. Miss June and I both do. We love you. We love our community. We love our county. We love all 120 counties in Kentucky. And we love all of our 50 states of the United States. In fact, we love the world and want to bring Jesus to the world, knocking on the door. The Holy Spirit's job to convict, God's job to judge, my job to love. That's our job.
to love. Every Christian's job to love. The greatest gift that God gave us is a gift of love. Thank you, and signing off. 859-750-0000. Don't forget, Box 50, Falmouth, Kentucky, 41040, zip code, to send in a little contribution to our radio station to paint those tires. God bless you. Have a great day now. Join us on Facebook and YouTube under Travels with John Stephenson. God bless you and have a great day.